this program I've talked about, the P program, which is a program that allows you to export your personal information in a standardized format that allows you to give your information to someone easily so you don't have to fill out forms. I feel like a lot of people have heard what I said and they thought, this guy is nuts. Why in the world would we want to give the government all our information? And what I would say to those people is, all you have to do is get onto the program, fill out all your information, export it, get back onto the program, change your information, and then leave it changed for a long time, because the longer you leave it changed, it would all the backups would change, and then you can go into a JSON editor, which is like a type of, it's kind of like a DBMS, a database management system. It's like a way of looking at the data, but it's a way of looking at the data if the data is in JSON format. So like if you have the data in comma separated values, you can turn that into a database also, and so you can turn JSON into a database. But you can also edit it using an editor. So you, as a person that doesn't trust the government, could theoretically, not theoretically, could actually not use the government program at all. You could have your friends show you their file, be like, hey, this is what my personal information file is that I give to employers. And then you go, oh, I'll just change out the information. So you just go into the, because a JSON file is just letters and numbers and stuff. It's called a string in computer science. So it's just strings, it's just characters. All you have to do is change the characters with, you could change it with a notepad. You could change it with all sorts of, you could probably change it with Microsoft Word and then just change the extension name at the end to make it .json. So you don't actually have to use the government's servers at all. But if we do the healthcare data thing where we do government healthcare, then people that are enrolled in the government healthcare program, which would be a lot less expensive than regular healthcare programs, because I would want to invest a lot of money making our health insurance super inexpensive, because we would own like generic drug manufacturers, and because I would buy out generic drug manufacturers, and I would try to buy out anywhere that is costing my insurance company a lot of money. So basically, if you did buy into this program, then no matter what, your information is going to be served on, is going to be stored on a server somewhere. But if it's healthcare data, then my opinion is that individuals shouldn't be able to remove their healthcare data without getting a doctor on board with moving the data, because I think that we need two-factor authentication, because you don't want someone being loose with their password and then saying this is the government's fault that my healthcare data ended up on the internet and everyone knows that I have an STD now and everyone hates me. You don't want that happening. So healthcare data needs to be super private, kind of like banking data. A lot of what I'm talking about is, okay, so in computer science, there are what they call standards. And so there's like TCP. Have you ever heard of TCP and IP and like UDP and stuff like that, and Bluetooth? Bluetooth is a standard. It's an industry standard. It's a standard that everyone agrees on. TCP is not the only way to do to transfer data. There are other ways to write TCP, but TCP is a really good way to do it. So everyone's kind of agreed, we're all gonna do it with TCP. So TCP is a way that computers communicate with one another. So everyone's agreed this is how we're gonna do it with our computers, so our computers work together. So what I'm talking about is an industry standard for exporting data about people, for personal information, and that's all I'm talking about. Like, if we have an industry standard for how the JSON objects are gonna be formatted, then what we have is a way for everyone to write computer programs, because they're like, oh, well, I can export my data in that format. I'm gonna come out with my own app because I know that no one trusts the government, and I'm gonna charge people $5 a year to store their personal data on my server. And but I mean, the reality is a lot of us would just use the government, and we would never even have the app on our phone unless we're applying for jobs or something. It's like, oh, I'm applying for a job, I need to go get the app. But all I'm saying is we can make it very easy for third parties to get involved, because what I've talked about specifically is having an API, which is my computer code works with your computer code. Your computer code can call my computer code. Like, using my computer code is super easy for you, because all you have to do is just call it. Because my computer code is like, I have a huge program. Like, the reason Oracle owns Java is because they have an API for Java. Like, it's for like making the code work. And that's what I'm talking about is an API, which I don't want to explain it, but yeah. So that's it. You can still have privacy and be able to use the P program, or just the P export type. It's a standard for exporting data. That's it.